open, public comment or citizen comment period. If you wish to address us on items not on the agenda, this is your opportunity to come forward.
Mr. Mayor and City Commission, this is Harold Save. I'm here possibly hoping to give some direction to the Commission and GRU in the upcoming contest with Greg, if there is a contest. Okay. We have a news flash, Mr. Mayor. Obama's White House rejects biomass as carbon neutral. White House policy statement was issued on June 23rd in response to House Resolution 2822, an appropriations bill. Appropriations bill that replaces science with wishful thinking. The Obama White House has issued a policy statement declaring strong opposition to a House Resolution 2822, a bill that would undermine President Obama's ability to put environmental reforms in place, and specifically rejecting calls to declare biomass fuels as carbon neutral. The White House says, quote, "The Obama administration objects to the bill's representation of forest biomass as categorically carbon neutral. Several studies, as well as the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, have determined that biomass fuel does indeed contribute to greenhouse gases. As proponents of biomass are only hopeful that growing more forests will diminish the impact of biomass smokestacks in the future." The policy statement categorically rejects biomass fuels as carbon neutral, saying the idea flies in the face of sound science. H.R. 2822 would dubiously label biomass as a renewable fuel source, but only if it fulfills the vague promise that forests will be replaced in several decades in order to achieve net carbon reduction. If you watch the news, you will see reports that future biomass forests in the western United States are being destroyed by giant fires as we speak. What's more, providers of biomass energy are not yet required to even document how their current carbon emissions will be reduced by future forests or afforestation. The can is getting kicked down the road on how future forests will keep up with CO2 from current biomass generation. The bill erroneously suggests that burning trees and power plants does not boost CO2 levels in the atmosphere if growth rate of U.S. forests exceeds the rate at which they're cut. That's tricky math, Mr. Mayor. This position of half-truths flies in the face of scientists who have repeatedly demonstrated that burning biomass does indeed increase atmospheric CO2 concentration and emits more CO2 per kilowatt than coal. Not only that, the bill ignores the fact that thousands of acres of forest globally are being clear-cut daily with no possible way for U.S. forests to make up this massive CO2 debt. Most importantly, short-term CO2 emissions cause additional warming decades before the new forests can possibly begin to reduce the global net carbon load. The near-term warming will come at the cost of more energy burned tomorrow and the next day in order to maintain indoor climate control worldwide.
You could move to a conclusion, please.
The Obama White House rejects biomass as carbon neutral for a good reason. Please support it.
Thank you for your comments. Next.